Hi, this is Viraya Pujari, School Assistant Social Studies, ZPSS Mudugulagudam, Kuravi Mandal. Second chapter, Ideas of Development. Today's topics to be discussed. Number one, understands the classification of the countries and knows the limitations of using averages. Good morning, children. Welcome again to our class, Ideas of Development. At the end of this lesson, you can understand the classification of the countries of the world, and you also knows the limitations of the averages while using comparison of the countries. My dear students, as you know that there are certain parameters or measures to measure different things. For example, the depth of the oceans is measured by units called fathoms. And the speed of aeroplane is measured by a measurement called nautical miles. The weight of an individual is measured by the kilograms. In the same way, there are certain measurements to measure the development of the countries. There are certain parameters used to compare the countries of the world. And today, you will know the classification of the countries. Classification of the countries. World Bank. It is also known as IBRD. IBRD means International Bank for Reconstruction and Development. It is categorized the countries of the world into three categories. In 2016, it has given a report. According to that report, it has classified the countries of the world into three. They are developed countries. And second one is that middle income countries. And third one is that underdeveloped countries. Let us come to discuss developed countries. Developed countries are also known as progressive countries, industrially developed countries, or advanced countries. According to the World Bank report, which are developed countries? The countries whose per capita income is more than $12,236 per annum are called developed countries. $12,236 and above are called developed countries. Which countries come under this category? Canada, United States of America, United Kingdom, these countries come in developed countries category. Then you come to discuss underdeveloped countries. According to the World Bank report, which are underdeveloped countries? The countries whose per capita income is $1,005, this is the symbol of dollar, US dollars are called underdeveloped countries. And which countries come under this category? The developed country, underdeveloped countries category, which countries come in it, into it? Number one, India, China, Pakistan, Afghanistan, these are all the examples of underdeveloped countries. Because of these countries, per capita income is less than $1,005. Then you come to discuss middle income countries. Which are middle income countries? The countries whose per capita income is above $1,005 and below 12,236 US dollars are called middle income countries. Which countries come under this category? Particularly OPEC countries. OPEC means Organization of Petroleum Exporting Countries. These countries come under the category of middle income countries. So this is about the classification or categorization of the countries of the world based on per capita income. And next we will come to discuss what are the averages, why should we use the averages to compare the countries of the world, are there any limitations while using the limitations. Let us discuss. And here is a chart. One table is there. You see the table here. This is the table used to compare different countries of the world. You see averages. Averages are the better indicator to compare the countries of the world. Already in the previous class, we have discussed that averages, per capita income is an average. So average is the better indicator and it is the good measurement to compare the development of the countries of the world, but they have certain limitations. Averages doesn't reveal the actual distribution of the income in a country. It hinders, it hides the actual distribution of the income. That we can understand by seeing this table. For example, you see here comparison of the countries with per capita income in rupees. For example, here two countries have been taken, country A, country B, and their monthly income of the citizen in these countries are shown here. In country A, first citizen is getting 9,500 rupees of income. Second citizen is getting 10,500. Third citizen is getting 9,800 rupees. Fourth citizen is getting 10,000 rupees. Fifth citizen is getting 10,200 rupees. When you come to B, here in B country, first citizen, second citizen, third citizen and fourth citizen are getting the same income, that is 500. Whereas the fifth citizen is getting 48,000 rupees. So what is the total income of the country A? 50,000. 50,000 by how many citizens are there? 5 citizens. 50,000 by 5 is equal to 10,000. This is the average income of a country A. Then you come to country B. Here up to 4 citizens they are getting the same per capita income, that is 500. But fifth citizen is getting 48,000. The total income is 50,000 by 5 citizen 10,000. Suppose if you have given the chance to reside either these countries, in which country do you like to stay or reside? Yes, you are correct. In A. Because in country A, almost all citizens are getting same income when compared with B. In B, you see, 4 citizens are getting less income, only 1 citizen is enjoying more income. But whereas in country A, all citizens are getting, you see, almost all the same income. So if you have given the chance, definitely you can reside in country A, because of in country A, income inequalities are less when compared with country B. In country A, all citizens are getting same income, income inequalities are less, and we can say that country A is developed when compared with B. In country B, all citizens, 4 citizens are very poor, only 1 citizen is rich. But the average income is same. Here you see, the average income doesn't revealing the actual distribution of the income in these countries. So that is why averages
used to measure, it is a better indicator to compare the countries. But sometimes you see, actually averages hides the actual distribution of the income. That you have to know today's lesson. By the end of the lesson, what you have understood? Number one, averages doesn't reveal the actual distribution of the income. And the second one is that classification, World Bank classified the countries of the world into three. What are those you have already understood? So tomorrow we will meet again in another class. And before completion of the class, you say, don't go out. While going out, use the mask. Thank you.